And welcome back to another great video on our YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to be telling you about three impressive FRP bypassing solutions that can be used in order to bypass your Google account. But before we go ahead and proceed, do make sure to go ahead and press that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos just like this moving forward, so you can get the best updates and latest updates coming from Wondershare Dr. Phone. Now let's go ahead and dive right in. So part one is going to be about three useful ways to bypass FRP without wasting a minute. We are going to start with our very first way to bypass FRP. So way number one is going to be to bypass Google verification through SMS. This potential bypass FRP method is a commendable way to bypass your Google account. With the help of just your SMS, it can bypass your Google account without any problem. I just look across the following steps in order to get to how to use the SMS method in order to bypass your Google account. So step number one is just going to be to make sure that you have a stable internet connection on your device and try to enter any email across your Google account verification procedure, and then find the option of send it via SMS. You should type a message on the next screen and send it to 112. A pop-up notification will appear on the screen related to the message not being sent, and then you will find a call button right next to it, so go ahead and click on that button. And then you can just dial the following prompt on screen in order to open the settings section here, and then perform a hard reset of your Android phone from here. And then once completed, your phone will just successfully bypass Google verification. And method number two is going to be by bypassing through Google Keyboard. So the second way in order to bypass FRP is going to be through Google Keyboard. So please go ahead and follow the steps provided right now. So first things first, I just initiate the process by resetting your Android phone and connecting it across a Wi-Fi network. On accessing the Google account verification interface, the keyboard is going to appear on screen, then tap on at. On the keyboard, in order to open the settings for your keyboard, and go ahead and tap on Google Keyboard settings from here. On the next window, you're going to click on the three dotted icon and then select help and feedback. And then you need to select using Google Keyboard in the help section. So following this, hold any text across the web page and click web search. And then as the search bar appears on the screen, go ahead and type in settings and then look for the option of about phone across this menu. So look for the build number and then go ahead and tap it 7 times in order to access your developer setup. And then click on OEM unlocking across the next window and click on the back button twice in order to execute this. Well, then finally, just go ahead and restart your device and connect with Wi-Fi to bypass Google account verification successfully. So method number three is going to be through Dr. Phone screen unlock. Since the previous method does not really operate if you don't have Google Keyboard across your Android device, and the last and most efficient way to bypass FRP for going across your Google account is through Dr. Phone screen unlock for Android. This method is quite easy and effective to execute. You will be able to bypass FRP in no time with this tool. I just go across the detailed steps of this tool and figure out how to perform FRP in order to bypass it in no time. So first things first, always go ahead and download and install the latest version of Dr. Phone on your desktop, and then launch the tool and access the screen unlock option from the homepage. And then you should have your phone connected to your computer with a good Wi-Fi connection. And select the unlock Android screen and FRP option in order to continue. On the next window, you need to select the option of remove Google FRP lock option for bypassing the Google account on your Android device, and then select the appropriate OS from the available options on the very next screen. So then connect your Android device with the USB cable, and once connected, a pop-up message will appear about your device information. So go ahead and confirm the message, and then you will receive a notification across your device. On receiving this notification, click view in order to proceed to the Play Store, and then you will have to install the dedicated browser on your device. And if it is already installed, click on open. And finally, open the browser. Add the URL that you're going to be seeing right on screen over here, and then once you're done with that part, just go ahead and click on enter from there, and then you should be good to go. However, if you have an Android device with Android 7 or 8, then you should look across these steps in order to be able to fix that issue. So on opening a new page on the browser, go ahead and click on Android 7 or 8, and then click on download APK. Then it's going to start to download the .apk file that you're going to need in order to continue with this process. So click on the open button after installing it. And if there is any certain security procedure in order to follow on your device, then proceed to the settings page in order to turn on allow from the source, and then move back to the installation from there. And they need to follow the guideline for completing the installation once you have completed the installation. So go ahead and click on done, and then revert back to the .apk download page, and then tap on the open settings button in order to lead into your device's settings, and then find and open the option of lock screen and security. In the next window, I just need to navigate to the other security settings option. So just locate the option of device administrators and disable the Android device manager and find my device services on your smartphone. And while disabling services, click the deactivate button to confirm your decision. So then go ahead and access your device's settings and find the apps option from the list and find the Google Play services and Google Play Store to disable them separately on your device, and then reopen the settings of your device and find the clouds and accounts option. So then go ahead and click on accounts for managing the accounts across your device and click on add accounts and select the Google sign in with an existing Google account. Conversely, you can add a new account if you want as well. And once logged in, go ahead and click on I agree in order to successfully add and reaccess the settings from here. Open the lock screen and security option, and then proceed over to the other security settings option, followed by device administrators, and enable the services of Android device manager and find my device and you previously had to disable. So just restart the Samsung device after completing these steps and follow the on-screen steps in order to launch your device again as they're being shown. And then you have successfully bypass your Google FRP, no problem. So part two is going to be pretty much the FAQ section here. So for example, what do you mean by an FRP lock on an Android device? So factory reset production, also known as FRP, is a special security feature provided on Android devices greater than OS version 5.1. Under this feature, you need a Google email address and password for factory resetting. Without any email address and password, your device can get locked and you won't be able to access it after the fact. So as your device is registered across your Google account, the FRP lock is enabled across it. Thus, you look for methods in order to disable the FRP lock-in conditions where you forgot your password. So what do you do if the keyboard method or the keyboard in general just does not open on your device? There are some smartphone models and brands that do not let the keyboard settings appear on the screen. So for this, you should just use a proper unlock tool for effective results like Dr. Phone Screen Unlock for Android. So one more thing, is your Google account removed after the factory reset? The Google account is going to be removed after performing the factory reset on your device, but you can still access the data from the account by signing back in using the email address that you use across your Android device. So, in conclusion, there was a lot to gain here, wasn't it? We hope that you've noted all of the key points about the methods to bypass FRP easily. And if you have any questions, come with your queries in the comment section and we will be more than happy to answer you. Go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe to OneAssure Dr. Phone for more amazing videos just like this one. Now, until next time, have a good one.